Welcome to our Mystery Sleep Stories channel, your sanctuary for meditation and a peaceful sleep. Immerse yourself in the soothing embrace of sleep-inducing tales, carefully crafted to transport you to mysterious lands. Let the gentle rain and serene sounds of nature accompany you on this quest for deep sleep. Say goodbye to restless nights and welcome the embrace of a restful sleep with our mystery bedtime stories. So, let the tale begin. The Shadow of the Cursed Night. Chapter 1. The Legend of the Black Knight. In medieval Europe, whispers of the Black Knight's cursed armor reached every tavern and hearth, spinning tales of betrayal and darkness. His legend cast a shadow over the Rhine Valley, a region dense with ancient forests, forgotten ruins, and eerie fog. The story spoke of a once honorable knight who fell to darkness after betrayal by his comrades. His armor, bound by a powerful curse, was scattered and hidden across the land, guarded by specters and traps that repelled all who dared search for it. Roland, a seasoned knight who had heard these tales throughout his life, became enthralled by the mystery. Determined to find the armor and learn the truth, he ventured into the Rhine Valley's mist-covered woods, guided only by the fragmented stories he had collected from villagers and bards. With his sword at his hip and shield slung across his back, he followed a winding path deep into the forest. As the fog thickened and the trees grew denser, he stumbled upon an ancient stone pathway, its edges cracked and overgrown with ivy. The path led to the crumbling remnants of a fortress hidden within the forest, its once imposing walls now covered in moss and vines. Roland approached cautiously, his eyes scanning the mist for movement. As he neared the entrance, flickering shapes began to materialize. Spectral figures stood guard at the archway, their translucent forms swaying like flames. Their hollow eyes met his, and the air around them crackled with energy. They challenged him with riddles and illusions, weaving false paths and mirages that twisted the ruins into a labyrinth. One riddle involved deciphering the true name of the Black Knight, while another demanded he recount the twisted tale of betrayal that had doomed the knight to eternal unrest. Roland drew upon his wit and experience, answering each riddle with care and piercing through the illusions with his unwavering resolve. After passing the spectral trials, the ghostly guardians receded into the mist, and Roland stepped through the archway into the ruins. The fortress was dimly lit by the moonlight filtering through the fog, revealing empty halls and long-forgotten chambers. The air was thick with the scent of decay, and his footsteps echoed off the stone walls. He wandered deeper into the fortress, searching for any clue that could lead him to the Black Knight's armor. He found a dusty scroll in one of the abandoned rooms, its brittle pages covered in faded runes that hinted at hidden passages within the ruins. Guided by the scroll, Roland discovered a concealed door hidden behind a tapestry depicting a coat of arms. He pushed open the door, revealing a winding staircase that led down to a chamber beneath the fortress. The chamber was illuminated by the moonlight streaming through a crack in the ceiling. At its center stood an ornate chest, its lid adorned with intricate carvings and secured by a complex mechanism. Roland examined the chest closely and noticed that it contained a series of sliding tiles that formed a puzzle. He carefully slid each tile into place, revealing a pattern that matched the crest on the tapestry above. With a final click, the mechanism unlocked, and the lid of the chest swung open. Inside, resting on a velvet lining, was the first piece of the Black Knight's cursed armor. A gauntlet, dark and etched with symbols of betrayal. Roland held it up to the moonlight, marveling at the craftsmanship and the aura of power that radiated from it. He slipped it onto his hand, feeling a chill as the cold metal clasped around his wrist. The gauntlet seemed to pulse with energy, and Roland knew it would guide him to the other pieces scattered across the Rhine Valley. He sheathed his sword and left the ruins, stepping back into the mist-covered woods with renewed determination. The gauntlet's whispers would lead him onward, deeper into the mystery of the Black Knight's curse. Chapter 2: Ghosts of the Haunted Castle. Having claimed the gauntlet of the Black Knight, Roland ventured onward through the mist-covered forest, following the ancient stone pathway until he stood before the abandoned fortress. The fortress loomed like a ghostly sentinel, its crumbling walls and ivy-covered towers reaching into the night sky. The air around it was thick with the scent of decay and neglect. Torches flickered faintly at the entrance, casting long shadows across the mossy stones and hinting at the presence of restless spirits within. Roland crossed the threshold cautiously, his sword drawn and shield raised. The grand hall was dimly lit by the waning moonlight filtering through the broken windows, illuminating the faded banners and tattered tapestries hanging on the walls. The air was cold, and the silence was broken only by the echo of his footsteps on the flagstones. As he ventured deeper into the castle's labyrinthine halls, he felt a chill wash over him. Spectral forms began to materialize in the gloom, their hollow eyes fixed on him. The ghosts spoke in fragmented whispers, their voices echoing off the stone walls like distant cries. They were the souls of those betrayed by the Black Knight, bound to the castle by the darkness that had consumed them. Each spirit guarded a secret, revealing clues through riddles and cryptic symbols scrawled across the walls. Roland listened carefully, piecing together their half-formed whispers and following their spectral trails down winding corridors. Their riddles guided him to hidden passages, where he uncovered symbols and sigils carved into the stones. He deciphered these clues, leading him to a room sealed behind a tapestry bearing the coat of arms of a long-forgotten family. He tore away the tapestry to reveal a narrow door and descended a spiral staircase into the castle's depths. The air grew colder with each step, and he could hear the distant moans of spirits echoing through the walls. He finally emerged into a vast chamber, lit only by the moonlight filtering through a crack in the ceiling. The chamber's walls were lined with shelves of dusty scrolls and relics, hinting at a treasure trove of forgotten knowledge. In the center of the chamber stood an ornate chest locked with a complex mechanism. The lid was adorned with an intricate crest and an array of tiles arranged in a grid pattern. Roland examined the mechanism closely, realizing that the tiles formed a puzzle that required solving to unlock the chest. He carefully slid each tile into place, deciphering the pattern until it revealed the crest of the Black Knight. With a final click, the lock disengaged, and the lid swung open. Inside, resting on a velvet lining, was the second piece of the Black Knight's armor. a gauntlet etched with symbols of betrayal and loss. As Roland reached for the gauntlet, the air grew frigid, and a ghostly wind swept through the chamber, extinguishing the torches. The specters that had guided him materialized around the chest, their hollow eyes watching his every move. He held the gauntlet high, and the spirits wailed, fading back into the darkness. The castle walls shook, and the stones groaned as if the ancient curse binding the spirits had been partially lifted. Roland secured the gauntlet to his belt and left the chamber, the spectral moans still echoing in the halls behind him. He climbed back up the spiral staircase and emerged into the moonlit courtyard. The castle walls stood more ominously now, the fog swirling around the towers like a shroud. The second gauntlet pulsed with energy, whispering faintly of a lost village where the remaining pieces of armor could be found. Roland sheathed his sword and left the castle, making his way down the mist-covered stone path toward the ruins of the abandoned village at the forest's edge. There, he would continue his search, guided by the whispers of the cursed gauntlet and the secrets of the restless spirits. Chapter 3: Shadows in the Abandoned Village. With the two gauntlets of the Black Knight securely fastened to his belt, Roland set his course toward the abandoned village at the edge of the forest. The mist clung to the trees like a spectral veil as he navigated through the underbrush, listening to the whispers that seemed to emanate from the gauntlets. They spoke of a well, hidden deep within the ruins of the forsaken village, that guarded the entrance to the Black Knight's stronghold. After hours of trekking through twisted trees and thorn-covered vines, Roland reached the outskirts of the village. The homes were reduced to crumbling ruins, their stone walls covered in ivy and moss. Skeletal trees leaned over the narrow paths, casting long shadows across the rubble-strewn ground. The village square lay at the heart of the settlement, dominated by a well that stood like a silent sentinel amidst the decay. Roland approached the well cautiously, holding his torch high. Its stone walls were chipped and cracked, and the rope that once held a bucket had long since rotted away. Peering into the well, he saw nothing but darkness. He tied the torch to his belt and began his descent, gripping the crumbling stones as he lowered himself into the depths. The well's shaft was narrow, and the air grew colder with each step. At the bottom of the well, Roland found a narrow tunnel leading through the earth. He crawled through the tunnel on his hands and knees, emerging into a labyrinth of caves hidden beneath the village. His torch cast flickering shadows on the rocky walls, revealing stalactites that hung like jagged teeth from the ceiling. The air was damp, and the distant sound of dripping water echoed through the caverns. Roland stepped cautiously, his gaze sweeping the ground for traps that might have been left by the Black Knight's followers. As he ventured deeper into the labyrinth, he noticed faint markings on the walls, symbols that seemed to guide him toward the heart of the caves. The air grew colder, and the faint glow of spectral light hinted at the presence of ghostly guardians watching from the shadows. At a narrow passageway, Roland noticed a pressure plate half buried beneath a layer of dirt. He carefully stepped over it, knowing that triggering it would likely release a deadly trap. He continued onward, dodging poison spikes that jutted from the walls and avoiding swinging blades hidden in the stalactites. the passage twisted and turned, eventually opening into a vast chamber lit by the eerie glow of phosphorescent fungi. In the center of the chamber stood a stalactite, hollowed out to form a small alcove. Resting inside was the third piece of the Black Knight's armor, the chest plate, adorned with the knight's crest and etched with symbols of treachery and despair. Roland reached for the chest plate, and as he did, the air shimmered with spectral energy, and ghostly figures materialized around the edges of the chamber. The specters raised their ethereal swords, their hollow eyes fixed on Roland as they glided closer. He slipped the chest plate onto his torso, feeling the chill of the cursed metal against his skin. With his sword drawn and shield raised, he faced the spectral guardians, striking at the air as their forms flickered and faded. Each blow seemed to weaken their hold on the cave. And with one final strike, the ghostly guardians wailed and vanished into the darkness. The cavern walls groaned as the energy dissipated, and Roland quickly made his way back through the labyrinth, past the traps, and through the tunnel leading to the well. He climbed back to the surface and stepped into the moonlit village square, his breath visible in the chilly air. The chest plate pulsed with energy, whispering faintly of a foreboding castle perched on a distant cliff. Roland sheathed his sword and left the ruins, guided by the whispers of the cursed armor toward the Black Knight's stronghold, where he would face his greatest challenge yet. Chapter 4, The Black Knight's Curse. With three pieces of the Black Knight's cursed armor in his possession, Roland journeyed toward the foreboding castle, perched atop a cliff. The castle stood like a grim silhouette against the moonlit sky, its spires rising like jagged fangs. Thunder rumbled in the distance, and the waves crashed against the rocky cliffs below. Roland approached cautiously, feeling the weight of the armor he had collected, and sensing the malevolent energy that pulsed from within the castle walls. He pushed open the iron gate and stepped into the moonlit courtyard, his footsteps echoing on the cracked stones. The castle's doors creaked as he entered the grand hall, its vaulted ceiling covered in cobwebs, and the walls adorned with faded banners. The flickering torches cast long shadows across the floor, and the air grew colder as he ventured deeper into the castle's depths. Each corridor was a maze of shifting floors and collapsing bridges, guarded by spectral illusions that sought to deceive him at every turn. Roland relied on his wit and the clues he had uncovered to navigate the traps, avoiding the pitfalls and sliding walls that threatened to seal him in. He finally reached a staircase that spiraled up to the grand hall, where the last piece of the Black Knight's armor rested on a stone pedestal. The room was illuminated by moonlight streaming through stained glass windows. On the pedestal stood the final piece, the helm, its visor down, and the crest of the Black Knight etched into the steel. Roland approached the pedestal cautiously and reached for the helm. As he lifted it, the torches in the room extinguished, and the air crackled with energy. A ghostly figure emerged from the darkness, the Black Knight himself, his spectral form clad in the cursed armor. His hollow eyes glowed with malice as he raised his sword and pointed it at Roland. In a voice that echoed through the grand hall, the Black Knight challenged Roland to a final duel, promising that victory would lift the curse and reveal the story behind his betrayal. Roland unsheathed his sword and raised his shield. The two warriors clashed, the sound of their blades echoing through the castle. Sparks flew as their swords met, and the Black Knight's spectral form twisted and shimmered with every strike. He wielded dark magic, conjuring illusions and shadows that made it difficult for Roland to land a decisive blow. But Roland fought with unwavering resolve, pressing the attack and using his shield to dispel the illusions that sought to disorient him. He struck at the Black Knight's spectral form, each blow weakening the knight's energy. The Black Knight let out a wail as Roland's sword pierced his armor, shattering the curse that had bound him for centuries. The spectral warrior collapsed to the ground, his hollow eyes fading as his spirit began to dissipate. With his last breath, the Black Knight revealed how he had been betrayed by his comrades and consumed by bitterness. He had sworn vengeance, but his oath had only brought ruin and bound his spirit to the cursed armor. As the Black Knight's form crumbled into dust, the castle trembled, and the illusions that guarded it began to fade. Roland donned the helm and placed the remaining pieces of armor on the stone pedestal, fully assembling the Black Knight's armor. The moonlight illuminated the restored armor, and the castle's walls groaned as the illusions shattered into dust. The curse was lifted, and the spirits that had guarded the armor were finally at peace. Roland sheathed his sword and left the castle, emerging into the dawn's first light. He returned to his kingdom victorious, where the legend of the Black Knight's curse was transformed into a tale of redemption and the triumph of courage over darkness. The armor became a symbol of honor and redemption, and Roland's journey became one of the kingdom's most celebrated legends.